Hello everyone. In my last video, I taught you how to download and install a custom firmware like OpenWRT in your Netgear router. Today I will show you three proven methods on how to flash the stock firmware back to your device. Now this process is useful if you have bricked your device during the process or you like the stock firmware better. For me, the stock firmware was better due to the antenna modifications. Now you need to go to the Netgear website and download the stock firmware for your device. For my device, it is the R6850. So I am downloading the required stock firmware. Now unzip the firmware and put it somewhere in your desktop. It is the .img file. Now open the, connect the router, open the OpenWRT interface, go to system, then flash image. This is the first method. This is the simplest method. Now upload the image that you just downloaded. Click force upgrade and wait for the device to respond. For me, this did not work. Now the second method is the TFTP method. For the TFTP method, connect the router through the Ethernet port and go to the Ethernet settings and select the IP address and the subnet mask as you see in the screen. Then download a TFTP server like Pumpkin or SolarWinds TFTP. You can download any one of them. You don't need to download two like I did. Now click put file. Select the firmware you just downloaded. In the local file, select the firmware you just downloaded. Then select the remote host as 192.168.1.10, just as you selected the IP address of your Ethernet port. Now this is very important. Before you press enter, hold the reset button. While holding the reset button, power on your router and keep holding the reset button until you see the power and the USB LEDs flash alternatively. This process is very important. Now, after flashing for a few seconds, press enter. The image file has been successfully uploaded. Now you need to wait for some time before rebooting the router. If successful, this process will work. If not, move on to the next process. Now this is the NMRP method. This method worked for me. Now download these two softwares, the NMRP Flash and the NPCAP. The links are in the description below. Now unzip the NMRP Flash, disable all other network adapters except your Ethernet adapter. Now go to the NMRP Flash unzip folder and enter commands like this. Open a command prompt window, then enter NMRP flash space hyphen capital L. The case is very important. It will return the address, interface address of your Ethernet. For me, it is NAT17. Now write NMRP flash.exe hyphen I space NAT17 hyphen F space factory.img. For I have written factory.img. You just specify the file name, whatever file name you have given for your stock firmware that you downloaded from the Netgear website. Now wait for the firmware to flush. It will take many minutes, around 15 to 20 minutes. Don't get impatient. Don't turn off your router or computer. Now, this video is sped up. So, you need to wait. I have sped up the video. You need to wait a lot more than this real-time video. This video is not real-time. Now this waiting for the remote to respond, this process will take some time. For me, it took around 20 minutes. Has been flushed successfully. You can see that my router is now running the stock firmware successfully. So that's it, guys. If you have any queries, let me know in the comments below.